Hey guys, it's iDavis from the Czech community, and in this official webinar video tutorial, I'm going to bring you all the information that you need to know to get started with Ancient Wonders, handle all the demons from fellow players that you are going to face, and give you some of my opinions about which wonders should definitely take a place in your city. But before we start, make sure you are subscribed to our channel so you always stay up to date with latest from Elvenar. Let's begin by taking a look at the second chapter of the research tree. Around the middle of this chapter, you can find the technology Secret Ancient Wonders, which by unlocking gives you access to the Ancient Wonders feature. You can access Ancient Wonders by pressing this button in the navigation bar. This opens the list of all wonders that you have already unlocked, and you can also see which wonders you can unlock in the future. By researching this technology, you immediately get access to the two very first Ancient Wonders, Tome of Secrets and Golden Abyss, and you will unlock more of them as you will progress in the game. Before placing an Ancient Wonder in your city, you first need to fulfill its requirements. For each wonder, this includes completing its rune circle by collecting and activating 9 pieces of rune shards. Each wonder has its own type of rune shards that you can collect within many features of the game, including provinces on the world map and tournaments, which can provide you a bunch of rune shards every week. After you successfully collect rune shards for your desired wonder, you can start activating its rune circle in the corresponding tab of the Ancient Wonder. You begin with inserting your rune shards into the circle, but be aware, every time you try to insert a shard, the game randomly picks one of all possible slots of the circle, so it might try to activate one that was already activated. Should this happen, the rune shard will break into a broken shard, which is another valuable item. Once you collect 10 broken shards, you can use them for any Ancient Wonder to automatically activate one of its missing runes. Keep in mind that the number of broken shards you can store is limited, as you can always only keep up to 10 broken shards at a time. Keep an eye on the counter and use your broken shards every time you reach the maximum. Well, once you build the Ancient Wonder, it starts providing a magical effect for your city. This effect becomes stronger every time you upgrade your wonder, and an interesting fact about Ancient Wonders is that once you build the wonder into your city, its size will always be the same, even after any number of upgrades you make. So from that moment on, you can keep increasing its power without consuming any additional space in your city. For leveling your wonders, you primarily need knowledge points, where I can assure you, the number of knowledge points you will need increases significantly the farther you advance. The specific number depends on several factors, like level of the Ancient Wonder, each level requires more than last, and also size of the wonder plays a role, as the costs of bigger wonders usually go higher. Every 5 levels of the wonder, you will need rune shards instead of knowledge points, as you will need to rebuild the rune circle again, so keep collecting the rune shards even after initial placing of the wonder in your city. Moving on, let's take a look at one of the most remarkable early wonders that should definitely take a place in your city. Let's talk a bit about what kind of effects it actually provides, how does its effect actually work, and why is it so great and you should definitely not avoid getting one for your city. It's the Golden Abyss, which is in my and also many other players' opinion one of the best wonders in the game. What this wonder provides is a number of coins that you can collect every 3 hours, but what is especially the reason why people love this wonder so much is population. It's one of the smallest wonders but can squeeze so many people in there. Let's take a closer look at how the provided population is calculated and how much of a positive impact it can have for your city. The population the Golden Abyss provides depends on how much working population your city has. Based on its level, the wonder gives you some percentage of working population back. For example, let's take a look at what happens at level 10. It provides 6%, so if you have 100,000 working population, this wonder gives you 6,000 additional population. Now, when you upgrade a wonder, the percentage increases, hence you immediately get some more population from there, so it may seem like a one-time reward, but do not forget that it's calculated based on your working population. So now, anytime in the future, when you build some building that consumes population in your city, it will consume less based on the wonder's current percentage impact. This is the wonder that should definitely be found in every city, since its effects are important for every player in the game, no matter what his game style is. Not every wonder in the game fits these general requirements so well, so you should always consider how much the effect of your desired wonder fits your own lane and how well it suits your city advancement stage and plans. Choosing wonder should always be a precious decision, as getting them into higher levels might be very expensive, especially when it comes to the required knowledge points. But fortunately, this is the point where you are not alone and where your friends and fellows can help with leveling your wonders. Let's take a look at how it works. You can open a list of all ancient wonders of any player from the world map and donate your knowledge points into any of their wonders. This way, you help your fellows with leveling up their wonder, while you have the chance to receive rune shards of that wonder and also get ancient knowledge instance if you manage to be one of the top contributors after the research of the wonder is completed. To show which wonder you are currently working on, you can mark your wonder by this heart icon so that other players know where their help will be appreciated most. You can use the ancient knowledge instant directly in any of your own or other players' wonders and immediately donate the specific amount of knowledge points based on the instance value. A lot of ancient knowledge instants can be obtained in tournaments, where obtaining a lot of fellowship tournament chests is one of their best sources in the game. So in this case, the bottom line here is, being a part of strong fellowship will grant you a tasty dose of ancient knowledge instants every week and so will have a huge impact on your ancient wonders developing journey. And with that said, that has been it for this tutorial. I hope you found it useful, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.